We never had nothing here. We never had a like adult shopping experience. I lived out here 20 years of my life. I've never had something where I'm like, yo, I can go cop a fit. I can go get fly. Like, I never had that. So when he initially came to me and was like, yo, let's open a store in Far Rock, I'm like, all right, I don't know. He like, yo, we can make the neighborhood fly. Like, we can make these kids look dope and we can make a brand in the interim. My name is Terrell. I'm the owner of a store called The Crate. And we're here in Far Rockaway, New York. Initially, before I opened the store, we wanted to do a seafood restaurant. And my friend came up with the idea to do a clothing store. And predominantly somewhere where there wasn't anything, which was Far Rockaway, which where we grew up. It was never a dope clothing store or a dope clothing experience for that matter around this neighborhood. So we took it upon ourselves to try to embed something in the neighborhood that could, you know, kind of hold a little bit of a foundation. Well, what separates us from like what everybody else is doing is that my mind's always racing. I'm always thinking of the next best thing. I'm always thinking, when I walk down the street, I look for inspiration for when I create. I look for stuff around me for how I create. So it could be the simplest thing. I might see a sweatsuit, but I might see a little indentation of something. I'm like, oh, that's kind of cool. That's dope. I might take that. Even when I came up with the tie-dye tees, it was like I seen a couple homeless people, you know, walking around the neighborhood and they had on tie-dye tees. I'm like, damn, that's kind of dope. Surely enough, it came to light and people liked it. So that's just kind of, I just kind of try to stay a little bit ahead. Like I try to watch the fashion curve in a sense. Well, Sucker Free collab, that's my boy. Shout out to Sucker Free BC. Get your little plug there, right? So with him, it was kind of organic. We were opening the store and he's my friend. And I was just like, yo, listen, why don't somebody come up with a brand and we'll, you know, put it in the store and it'll be exclusively store in the crate. And went to BC and he was like, hell yeah, I got an idea. I'm saying, came up with it, and it was a hit from out the gate. I ain't even gonna front.
We're like brothers at this point. Whatever I do, they're a part of, and vice versa. I remember when they had the idea of opening the store, so I was there. I think I came up with the hats in like mid-August, and they came up, they still opened September, so it was like perfect timing. When I first did the hats, I only ordered 15, and everybody wanted one. I didn't even get to keep one. I got rid of all of them. One day I was just scrolling through the gram on the Explore page and there was a kid, he was selling hats. And I was like, I was actually gonna buy his hat. And I said, you know what, maybe I can make my own hat. And for the first time, I actually just followed through and I actually tried it and it worked.
Once I seen it, I was like, yeah, this is it. I was in a hotel room in Vegas and Cash, the weekend's manager, was like, I can't leave without that hat. Like, that's when I knew. I'm like, yo, he got something. He got something here. Yeah, there's been some pretty noticeable people that's wore our stuff. One, Money and Violence. Shout out to them. Shout out to the whole crew. We've had Ashanti. We've had Jewels, Trav. Shout out to Soul Bucks. They fuck with us. We had Ocho Cinco. 50 Cent showed us love when he wore one of the hats also. And then, of course, you know, most importantly, Chinx. That was, like, one of the hugest supporters. He was, like, a family member, basically, of the crate. He's somebody that both me and my partner had a lot of love for, you know? It was just genuine. Like, he didn't rock our shit because we told him to rock it. It was just something that he wanted to do. Before we even sold an item in the store, we gave back 300 book bags. He was here to take pictures with the kids, you know? And on a day like this, you might just see him pull up in the Porsche, you know, hop out. Yo, what's good? Everything good, y'all? What y'all up to? Unfortunately, his time was cut short, but his name, his legacy, will always live on as long as the crate exists. He, like us, loved the community, and I feel like it's mandatory that his legacy be kept alive as an acting catalyst for changing the community. I try to make sure that anything that's going on in this neighborhood, I'm somewhat involved. The crate is involved. I used to see little peers around me that might have needed help, and there was nobody in the neighborhood really doing that, giving back. They would just suck up the money. They would come, live in their houses somewhere else, but come to this neighborhood to make the money from the African Americans. Me being Black, African American, I am gonna give back every chance I can to my neighborhood. Down to a softball game that's going on right now. I got a team in the softball game. I sponsored them. Down to the Stack Bums tournament, we're heavily involved in that. Shout out to Manny.
Man, love to the crate. They support the neighborhood. They support the hood. I am the organizer of the Stop the Violence Stack Bundles basketball tournament. And Rel and the crate and his crew has been a blessing. They play in the tournament and they support. They help provide trophies for us. And I'm trying to get them to get a team in the tournament next year. You heard? Come here. I want to put it on camera. I need them to put a team in the tournament next year. What do you say?
The crate is amazing. I mean, they sponsored us. They helped us pay for our jerseys. There's a lot of single mothers and, you know, people who actually needed the help, and they definitely came through. They supplied us water, food. They paid for our jerseys. So they've been very, very helpful. And that's why we brought this winner.
Yes, shout out to the crate, though.
That's right. Look.
Crate gang. We appreciate you guys.
Yes, y'all are amazing. Thank you for everything.
Crate's been awesome to us. Great show love all around the board. Sponsored my team, his squad, back-to-back champs. Whatever we ask for, Crate delivers. No questions asked.
People do look at you like, okay, so what are they doing over there? But we're not doing anything. We're just trying to sell clothes, sell a couple hats, and just come up with a dope-ass brand that is not only impacting Far Rockaway, but it's impacting the United States. I don't want to just, this is bigger than New York. This is bigger than Nino Brown.